I first started experiencing anxiety actually pretty young, I would say. Probably around like 8 or 9. I would have a lot of nightmares. I would also experience, I wouldn't say anxiety attacks, but definitely episodes of really intense anxiety. At the beginning of the pandemic, there was just such deep isolation that I became like very, very lonely. I would go on my phone, go on social media, and look for that sort of dopamine fix.
Her whole social life was, you know, thumbnails on a laptop with strangers. Those were her peers. It was pretty awful for everyone, but particularly for the kids, I think.
These kids who have experienced the pandemic are experiencing symptoms that I didn't have to deal with when I was growing up. At least at the beginning of all this, nobody seemed to have a handle on how to treat this in a comprehensive manner.
The crisis in teen mental health has been a long-standing problem over many, many years. However, the pandemic, COVID-19, added fuel to the fire, and we don't have enough psychiatrists to take care of all the children and teens. My hope is that our mindfulness meditation TAR intervention that was developed by Eva Henge-Blom here at UCSF will treat and take care of adolescents who are suffering from depression.
I'm Jonathan Weinstock, and I'm an instructor for the Training for Awareness, Resilience, and Action program. Our classes include different mindfulness practices, breathing practices, as well as some sort of reflection discussion. This program really allows youth to hopefully connect with mindfulness in a way that's practical, that is supportive of what they're going through in their day-to-day life.
I'm really glad and I'm really grateful that the teachers were so involved. And I think it was really cool to see my brain. I mean, that was awesome.
In our brain change study, we don't just acquire MRI images of the anatomy of the brain, such as in this image. We also get much more information, for example, about the microstructure of the brain, the white matter connections, which are shown here. We did obtain preliminary results showing that there are indeed some changes in the regions related to emotional regulation and rewards in our participants.
I still look at those pictures. I have them in my phone, and if I swear I will meet people and I'll be like, hey, you want to see my brain?
There's a phrase in neuroscience that neurons that fire together wire together. What we hope to do is to find out what parts of the brain are responsible for resilience, and then to see if our TAR intervention increases those connections in the brain so that when they suffer from an increased time period of stress, they won't fall into another major depressive episode.
It's really scary, and it's really important to listen to your kid and to check in on them and to ask, you know, however within your culture, whatever is the way to ask that, how's your mental health or how's your mood or, you know, how's your spirit? You really have to ask those questions. You can't shy away from this. It's way too dangerous. It's really important.